Danny on the show.
I heard she cooked her special.
She did cook a special.
She was vegan. Mm. She had a little apron on. Tiny little.
She did the whole thing, actually. Yeah, she was very shishy in the kitchen.
And I imagine she, she would have been quite a boss in the kitchen because she was quite bossy.
She was.
I mean, not bossy, firm, because she does firm. Like to cook. So yeah. I imagine there'd be no messing about.
So she's quite strict, is she, in real life?
She can be, yeah.
She'd followed on, obviously, following your pop career. She's also gone through many sort of changes of image. But do you think you kind of egg each other on to better and greater things? It's quite a sportive relationship?
Possibly, yeah. I think more so than that, we're just both very determined in different ways. But the good thing about both being in the business and both doing similar things is if we're having a great day or a terrible day, and we speak with each other, you know that the other one...
Yeah.
You know, people can say, oh, I understand. Mm. But when she says I understand, I know that she...
And when one's down, the other sort of helps up.
Helps up.
We do. You know, we just... Beyond all that people might like to say, you know, or are looking for this great rivalry, we're sisters in the end, so...
So there's always been rivalry, and that's part of being sisters in a way, isn't it?
Yes.
But it doesn't mean that you don't kind of love each other or you don't have respect or anything like that.
Yeah.
I want to talk briefly about your website. You have a very cool website, I have to say.
Oh, thanks.
And there's a very good part on the website. You should check this out. And we'll get you the details after the break. And you can dress up Kylie.
You can.
So you can put you in a nurse's outfit.
Mm-hmm. French maid.
French maid. Quite saucy stuff.
You can give me the kettle, if you like. I can put the kettle on.
Have you not wanted to get something like quite a businessy suit? Like quite a kind of, not just the kind of, you know, nurse
saucier
stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, there's tracksuit pants
I haven't seen the tracksuit pants.
There's a pair of green tracky dacks, yeah. That's an Australian term.
Tracky dacks.
We like tracky
dacks.
Dacks is for trousers.
Tracky dacks.
Yeah. But she's probably due for a little update.
Yeah.
But check it out, yeah.
You see, in our day, we had Bunty, those sort of terrible sort of village things that you know...
Bend round.
Well, that's what I based it on.
In paper.
But this one you just have to...
Very technological.
Click and drag.
There's one of Mel on our website, actually. She's naked, but you can put pedal pushers on her and stuff like that. Or boiler suit. A very good boiler suit.
That's right.
In fact, if you go to our website, there is a hot link to Kylie's. So there you go. You can just get in there.
Yeah.
Now, a showbiz bird.
Okay. The showbiz
the
bird.
Showbiz. Can we have another look at the showbiz bird, just very briefly?
The showbiz bird.
If we can. We get to it. Don't worry about looking at the showbiz bird. I've slightly... Then we've heard the showbiz bird. It's an astonishing, clucking thing, that is. Now, the showbiz bird tells us you hate thick Australian accents. You hate them. Is that true?
Oh, no, I don't hate them. No. I think I used to have one.
What's a thick Australian accent?
Yeah. Well,
how does it work?
If you want to achieve this, you widen the mouth.
Elongate. Sherry Blair.
Sherry Blair.
Okay.
Right.
Now... Kind of square everything up, you know.
Yeah, kind of square everything up now.
Okay.
Is that better? Is that good? Was that
I think it's quite good. No, wait, no, that's wrong. I don't hate an Australian accent.
You just...
It's Australian, man.
But you, to be fair, have a very light Australian accent.
Yeah, I've been here for long enough, so...
6 years or something now.
I've been coming here for 10 years and I've lived here for 6-7 years.
And what is it about the UK that kind of makes you want to live here?
Well, firstly, it wasn't... a decision to come and live here was just that everything was happening here for in the time of Neighbours and then working with Stockett and Waterman, and I just love it here these days. Yeah, it's taken a long time to get used to being in London, but if I'm away, I really look forward to coming back.
Okay. Yeah.
Do you do an English accent? Do you do a London accent, for instance?
I probably could. Help me.
Northern accent. You do a Northern accent?
You have to speak at the back of your throat.
Aye.
Good.
That is good.
Well, what should we start with then?
We'll start with what's a really good Northern term?
Term.
Bye, et love. Good, very good.
Right, good lunches, isn't it?
And can you do a sort of posh?
Oh, well, yes, that's too easy. Well, we can all do that, can't we?
We can all do that. Because let's face it, that's where all the comedy's coming, and they're from that accent. That is very good. Chameleon Kylie. Have you been all around the country? Have you seen lots of...
Not all around the country, no. Lots of places.
It would be a long trip, I'd say.
Where have you not been that you really want to go to? In this GB island?
Actually, I don't know why, the first place that sprung to mind was Blackpool. I've never
Blackpool
been.
Blackpool is Blackpool.
My girlfriend's from there, and I keep saying I have to go to Blackpool and meet your family. So.
It is winner, man.
It's fantastic.
And they have a bigger thing with the lights, right?
The huge illuminations. It's a really good. It's a good town, Blackpool. Yeah. You should check it out. Mm-hmm. I just want to briefly ask you about the Spice Girls, because obviously they're very
Spice Summit.
So the Spice Summit.
We are at Spice Summit. Meeting.
What do we think? What do you think of the Spice Girls? Are you for? Are you against?
I'm for them. Yeah, because. Why not? I mean, it's horrible always having to have an opinion.
Yeah.
Sure. The Spice opinion.
Do what I do and never have one. I never have an opinion on anything.
Makes sense. Who? Who? But, no, they just are... I just marvel at what they're doing.
They're phenomenal.
The time where they had a different cover for each Spice Girl, I was, you know, my jaw dropped. Yeah. That is pure genius,
do you have
marketing
any sort of survival tips for them? I mean, they presumably will have to go on and reinvent themselves if they're going to carry on being successful, I would imagine.
I think they're doing pretty well at the moment. You know, people talking about, do you think this is the end of Spice Girls? And it absolutely isn't. Anything they do or don't do is going to be blown up and completely out of proportion by the press, by the people. It's like there's a constant public commentary on them, and, you know, they're still... Here we are talking about Spice Girls. It's definitely not the end of the Spice Girls.
It's proof that they're still around.
We should just live and let live.
Yeah.
That's the message we've learned.
Oh, ladies, let's join hands.
This is a Karen Jane moment.
We're going to carry on this kind of clinging, beautiful thing. But please join us after the break when Home and Away's bride-to-be Selena Cook, a.k.a. Tempany Deckett, will be introducing us to another Australian national dish. So, literally, we'll see you in three.
Tomorrow's show, when we'll be speeding through lunch with Fast Show stars Paul Whitehouse, Charlie Higson, Arabella Weir and Simon Day, plus celebrity chef Major Ron Ferguson.
Channel 4's tasty appetizer for the smorgasbord board that is afternoon TV.
Thank you very much, Dr.
Nocky. If you were really lucky, you'll have missed our tribute to Kylie earlier. Thank goodness she came on and saved us. But there's no escaping our second Thursday tribute to Australian soaps. In honour of both Kylie and Tempany, Home and Away's bad girl Selena Cook, we are proud, nay delighted to present young prison neighbours flying away home doctors. Australian for hello.
G'day.
G'day. G'day, neighbour.
Not anymore, Charlene. I'm leaving.
But why, Nolene? Are you going down to Mullabaroo to be written out of the series?
You know, no one ever comes back from there.
Except Harold.
But he'd lost his memory.
You, if you imagine his husband, when you forget about it for a while, just put it away in a pocket and
No, Bouncerine. I'm definitely leaving the series.
But why, Craighead? You're not defecting to retirement, Home and Away.
No. I'm bigger than Alf Ramsey Street, and I'm going off to be an international. I'm turning into John Noakes again. What's going on?
There was a bit of Queen in there. I'm getting off.
Does he have anything? I'm going to go and become an international pop star.
You've gone on accent walkabout, Arlene. What could you possibly offer the world of popular music?
Well, Arlene, I'm recording my new single of the week. So sorry. It's an insight into everything I hold dear about Oz culture. Tinnies glistening in the evening sun. Prawns smouldering on the griddle. Your mates diving into the swimming pool with their pants on their heads.
That's great, John. What's it called?
I'm a babby girl.
Sorry, Melanie, it's already been done.
Oh, well, Suline, I guess it's back to the wobble board as opposed to the drawing board.